Ex-girlfriend in Diagnosis Murder in half an hour on BBC One after today's drama at the mill.
Left 10 minutes ago.
I've told you about spending all your time on that thing.
I don't.
You should get out with some real people.
Mum!
You're late. School.
I'm going to take the day off, drop her at nursery, and then I'm going to catch up with some things at home. How long are you going to keep this up?
Hello, pumpkin.
You know I haven't been happy with work.
You're going to do some painting today.
I felt it was time for a change.
Do you know Mummy loves you? Lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and lots. And a little bit more. See ya.
I'm due at Angie's. Said I'd let the plumber in. I'll only be half an hour, so don't think you can come back here once I've gone.
Mum,
I know all the moves. Get off to school. Spend some time with your mates.
I haven't got any mates.
What about Lisa?
She's never liked me.
You used to hang out all the time.
Yeah, but she never liked me.
Karen?
She's got a boyfriend.
What about you? Anyone special? I'm only asking.
You're being embarrassing again.
Okay. I'd better get going. And so would you. See you later.
Dance in the morning.
This would be brilliant.
Yeah.
Mum and Dad not here?
No, Dad's on her list. Mum's at my Auntie Jones in Birkenhead. Fella's been throwing her about again.
How is she?
A handful.
Must be great though, being a mum.
Yeah, it's the best thing that ever happened. How's school?
Rubbish. You're lucky.
Well, I'm taking her for a walk in a bit. You fancy her?
Yeah.
Shoes!
Got a headache.
Yeah, well, you're not putting them on your head, are you?
Hurts.
You'll feel better when you're at school.
I don't want to go.
Why not?
I just don't want to.
Mrs. Bailey's still a right cow. She gave me another detention last week.
Oh, what did your mum say?
She doesn't know. I'm not going to tell her everything, am I?
You already for your GCSEs?
Not that bother, really.
Oh, I quite miss school sometimes.
You're joking, aren't you?
Well, obviously not for the lessons, just my mates.
So they come and see you?
Sometimes.
Never mind it. You got Rachel. It's got to be better than double maths.
You're not wrong there.
Mind you, just about anything's better than double maths.
What the hell are you playing at?
Well, just keeping Kelly company.
School's that way. Excuse us, Kelly. You and me need to have a talk.
Karen. Look, open up, sweetheart. Taryn, Mummy's not angry with you, but if Darren's still bullying you, then we've got to do something about it. You and me, together. Come here. It's going to be all right, OK? It's going to be fine.
I've not got a clue what goes through your head sometimes.
We're just talking.
And I told you to go to school.
I'm 16, I can do what I want.
I just want you getting an education.
I hate it.
You need those GCSEs.
Why?
So you can get yourself a proper job.
Maybe I don't want a job.
What are you going to live off then?
I don't know.
I'm not keeping you. After them exams, you're on your own.
I'll leave home if that's what you want.
To live where exactly?
I don't know.
And how are you paying for it? Got yourself some rich sugar daddy?
Might have.
Fat chance of that.
You saying I can't get a boyfriend?
Not one who'll keep you while you sit at home staring at your computer, no. You want out of here, you're going to have to work for it.
Well, maybe I'll win the lottery.
Bought any tickets recently?
No.
Going to struggle there then, aren't you?
Well, the councillor found me somewhere.
Why?
I'd be homeless. They're after.
Suit you down to the ground, that would. Everything on a plate, not having to work for it.
Yeah, but they give me the flat upstairs. It's been empty for ages.
That's a three-bed flat.
Well, I could share with Kelly.
She's got a home. So have you come to that.
Well, they'd have to find me somewhere. It's the law.
They got priorities, families, people with kids. Barking teenagers don't come very high up on the list.
I am not barking.
You'll be at the back of a very long queue.
Well, maybe I just moved up it a bit.
Why? Thinking of turning yourself into a single-parent lesbian or something?
Sort of, yeah.
Please, don't say this is you coming out.
No way am I gay.
What is it, then? What's your master plan for getting yourself a council flat? Let me guess. Going to get yourself up the duff so you can scam a free flat?
No. I already have.
You what?
You heard. I'm pregnant.
Has he hurt you?
He calls me names, him and his gang.
Yeah, but has he hit you? No, well, that's something anyway.
I want to go to the other school, the one Granny G talks about.
Look, we're going to sort this with Darren. We're going to make him stop.
You can't.
Maybe he's not such a bad lad after all.
What?
I'm just saying, he doesn't have a very easy life at home.
His mum's a slapper.
Who's taught you words like that?
Lee Johnston.
Look, she's got a few problems, that's all. And maybe that's why Darren behaves the way he does.
You're taking a side.
No, it's not about taking sides, Taryn. He's just a kid like you.
He's not like me.
Yeah, well, he's the same age as you.
I'm not a bully, am I? I don't go around hitting kids and calling them names.
You've got to be brave.
That's easy for you to say. You're not there.
Look, I'm going to sort this, Taryn. I promise.
How?
Have I ever let you down before? No. And I won't this time. Now, come on. It's going to be late.
You cannot possibly be pregnant.
Why? Because you didn't see the smoke coming down the chimney.
Who's the father?
The lad at school.
Oh!
Oh, it doesn't matter.
Yes, it does. He's got responsibilities.
I haven't told him yet.
About time you did, then.
I'll have it on my own.
What?
And Kelly manages.
She's got her mum and dad.
I've got you.
How did it happen?
How do you think?
This is no time to get clever. Did he make you?
Oh, no!
How far gone are you?
I don't know exactly.
You must know, unless you've done it more than once.
No, just once.
How long, then?
About 3 months.
And you're absolutely positive?
Yeah, I missed a couple of periods and did a home test.
What did the doctor say?
I didn't go. Well, I was too embarrassed.
Then how can you be sure?
I went to the clinic and got a scan.
You can't be pregnant. You're just a kid.
Look.
When did you get this done?
A couple of weeks ago. Scanned it into the computer and then copied it on my phone so I could carry it with me all the time.
Why didn't you tell me?
Why do you think?
Boy or a girl?
Said I'd rather wait.
Is it all right?
I suppose.
You suppose?
Oh, they never said it wasn't.
Get your coat on.
Why? Where are we going?
The doctors.
No way.
You've got to get yourself checked over properly.
Well, they've done that at the clinic.
You need regular checks.
But why? I'm fine.
This isn't like school, Leanne, where you miss a day and the worst that happens is you get a detention. I'm going to be a granny. We've got to make sure that this kid's okay, so regular checkups starting now.
Oh, but Mum, there's no need.
There is.
Yeah, well, if you'd like to pop in later, we'll see what we can do, OK? Thanks, bye. If you'd like to take a seat.
Not Donna?
Apparently not. Listen, can you fit in one extra patient today?
Yeah, OK. As long as you think I can manage.
Oh, Jimmy.
Morning!
Morning? It's a bit late, isn't it?
Can I ask her?
I know.
Where have you been?
Tarrant is being picked on again. I had to go and speak to the head.
I've been rushed off my feet here.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry. It won't happen again.
OK, listen, I've done the list, except for Joe, who's got drop and clinic this morning and emergency visit this afternoon.
OK, thanks.
Phone, Donna.
Yeah, sorry. Hello, my husband, how can I help you?
Problem?
Yes, wrong Mrs. Lovedone.
Excuse me a second. I'll find it for you, George.
No, it's fine. Job's worth doing, it's always worth doing yourself.
Morning. Brought your crystals.
Oh, no, I left them home. I'm popping back later on my broomstick to get them.
Problems?
Let's hope the patients are less trouble.
I want to see a doctor, and I want to see one now.
I haven't seen you for a while, Leah. How's things?
She's pregnant.
Congratulations.
Don't see how it's anything to be happy about.
Well, what do you think, Leanne?
I suppose the least we can do is make sure it's OK.
If I could just have a few words with Leanne.
Be my guest.
First question's a bit obvious, really, but are you sure you're pregnant?
That's what I said.
Of course I am.
Showing the scan? Too embarrassed to come here, so she says. Or to confide in her own mother.
Can you blame me the way you bang on?
Here.
Where did you get this done?
The hospital.
Well, St. Phil's?
Yeah.
And when was that?
I don't know.
Roughly?
A couple of weeks ago.
Do you have the original?
Yeah.
Can I see it?
Oh, it's at home.
Well, there's nothing in your notes. They should notify me as your GP.
Perhaps they forgot.
Oh, it's possible, but I doubt it.
Maybe it got lost in the post or something.
I expect so. So, how far gone did you say you were?
3 months. Only did it once, so she says.
Well, that's all it needs sometimes.
Is that it? Can I go now? Sit yourself down.
It's all right, Mrs. Chambers. I can deal with this. Now, I do need to ask you a couple of other questions, if that's OK.
Can I get you anything? Kettle's just boiled.
Nothing, thanks.
Is everything OK?
Yeah, sure. Why wouldn't it be? Dreaming of happier, more simple times.
Mm.
Before mobile phones.
Before husbands, more like.
She's still in a strop?
Domestic.
How does Jimmy seem to you?
He's fed up, but he'll get over it.
As long as we get through the end of the day without a fight breaking out.
Well, I shan't be starting one, unless it's with someone much smaller than me.
Very funny.
Are you feeling well?
Yeah.
Any nausea? Morning sickness.
A bit.
I've not heard you.
Not actually being sick, just feeling it a bit.
Must have come as a bit of a surprise.
Not round our way it isn't. They're all at it.
That is so not true.
What about Kelly? She was only 15.
There's nothing to do with Kelly. Me and her are different.
In what way?
She's popular.
And you're not?
Popular enough, so it seems.
Shut up, will you?
Don't you speak to me like that.
Please.
I'll speak to you how I like.
If you could wait outside a while, then I can examine Leanne.
What do you need to examine me for?
Well, to make sure that everything's okay.
Well, it is. They said so at the clinic.
I can arrange for you to see a lady doctor, if that's a help.
I don't want to see anyone. I'm only here because she made me.
You've got to see a doctor sometime.
Why? There's nothing wrong with me.
Maybe we could just have a chat.
I'm not seeing anyone. Leanne!
What did the school have to say?
Oh, they're monitoring the situation.
Leanne, come back here!
I'm sure it'll sort itself out.
Oh, you sound just like Ash. You'll be saying it's character building next.
Well, isn't the first kid this has happened to?
But it's the first of my kids it's happened to, and that makes a difference.
Yeah, I know.
Besides, it's not just him I'm worried about. I'm not sure it's entirely Darren's fault.
What, somebody made him go around picking on his classmates?
No. I met his dad. And he reckons his mum's to blame for a lot of his problems.
Yeah, but he would say that, though, wouldn't he?
No, he was a decent guy, Michelle. He wants Darren living with him. He doesn't like her.
So Darren just got stuck in the middle?
I kind of feel sorry for him. I mean, he's just a kid at the end of the day.
Oh, Mr. McAllister, would you like to come through?
Look, I'm a bit busy.
I need to talk to you.
You back, Mum?
What's up with her?
I don't know. She just won't stop crying.
She was all right before. Really cute.
Oh, she's a baby, Leanne, not a doll.
I suppose we do cry sometimes.
Yeah, but not like this. It's dead when we got back and she's just not stopping.
Well, have you given her any medicine?
Well, I don't know if I should.
Shh. What about your mum? She'll know what to do.
Oh, she's not answering her phone.
She's supposed to have that rash.
Oh, I wish my mum was here.
We tried changing her.
Oh, and what difference is that going to make?
Oh, I don't know. I've seen them do it on the telly.
What about your mum? Is she in?
Well, we had a row. That's what I wanted to talk to you about.
Please, Leanne, I really don't know what to do.
Mum, I'm at Kelly's. Something the matter with Rachel.
Bye, Mr. McAllister. Look, I know Darren's not had an easy life, but that's no excuse for him to start picking on Taryn, though, is it?
No.
And the other day, you were all up for putting him against a wall.
Yeah, well, that was before I found out how tough things are at home.
Donna, you've already got one kid. You can't be his mum too.
Yeah, I don't want to be. I just wish he had a better one than he's got at the moment.
You better not be messing me about.
She's really poorly.
She won't stop crying and she's got a rash.
We'd better call a doctor.
It'd be a great job if it weren't for all those patients.
That's it. I'm only treating well people from now on.
Whatever it takes to cheer you up.
Oh, is that obvious?
Well, I thought you'd be in a better frame of mind after your victory the other day.
Well, it would appear that I'm not the only Woodson in the house who's in need of a change of direction.
Bracken joined the SAS, is she?
No, Ronnie.
He's joined the SAS.
No, he's resigned.
Why?
You tell me.
Haven't you asked?
That would involve talking to him. Well,
glad to see you dealing with it like a grown-up.
Well, he could have discussed it with me.
You had been preoccupied.
Yeah, with my future. It's important.
And his isn't.
Well, an explanation would have been nice.
It's a bit hard if you're not speaking. Talk. More to the point, listen.
Ronnie, it's me. You buy me lunch where you can still afford it.
Is it meningitis?
I don't think so.
They say we have to look out for...
It's probably just a mild viral infection.
Well, can you make it better?
She's running a bit of a temperature, but some of her favourite pink medicines should help that. And plenty of fluids.
So she's really OK?
Really. Keep an eye on her, but she should be fine by tomorrow. And call me if you're worried.
You heard the doctor. She's going to be fine.
Yeah, until next time. Or until she wakes up in the middle of the night and won't go back to sleep. Or if she messes herself after I've just changed and have to do it all over again.
You said that being a mum was the best thing that ever happened to you.
Yeah, it can be, when she's asleep or when we're dancing in the morning.
You look so happy.
I just wish I would have stayed on at school. I could have got a proper job.
You still can.
Oh, get real. I mean, I love Rachel, but she's ruined my life. She's ruined it.
It can be a tough job being a mum on your own. Isn't that right?
She does okay, don't you?
Wake up and smell the coffee, Leanne. This could be you in a few months' time.
Don't even think about it.
Too late for that.
You're never pregnant.
Yeah.
Oh, you stupid, stupid cow.
Good luck.
What do you get for killing your husband these days?
Depends on whether you've got just cause or not.
There's not a court in the land that'll convict me, then.
I'm going to a new sandwich place. Can I bring you something back?
No, fine, thanks.
Any news from the school, then?
Nothing.
Well, there you go.
Yeah, well, Darren's probably cut the phone lines and he's holding the head teacher hostage in the staff room.
They'll sort it out.
I hope so.
Of course they will, don't worry. You've done everything you can.
I thought you'd be pleased.
Pleased?
Well, to have a mate go through the same as you.
And you really want this?
Well, we could hang out together. Maybe get a flat.
And throw our lives away at the same time, you mean?
No. You're popular. You've got loads of friends.
Yeah, Leanne, I did have.
Can Kelly, do you remember when you first found out you were pregnant? How excited you were. Really looking forward to being a mum.
You won't be the first kid who thought having a baby would solve all your problems.
It's a really special thing, being a mum.
See?
Is that what you want, Leanne, too? To be special?
People would notice me if I had a baby.
I think you'll make a really great mum, like Kelly.
Thanks.
But, Kelly, what if you could turn the clock back?
How do you mean?
To just before you got yourself pregnant. Would you have done the same again?
I'm not sure.
Clearly you love Rachel, and that changes things. But imagine it's a year ago, and the baby never existed. Would you still have made the same choices?
Well, I wouldn't have let her move in a million miles of me.
Listen to her, love. You could get rid of it.
No! Still have a life of your own.
I don't want to be on my own.
Oh, you'll meet someone when you're old enough.
You can't take my baby away from me.
But I think you're forgetting something, aren't you, Leah?
What?
There is no baby. You're not actually pregnant, are you?
I've been turning things over in my head a lot recently, not knowing what to do.
Well, you can talk to me about it.
You're too busy.
Too busy to listen?
Usually, yeah. And even when you do listen, you don't take any notice, if you know what I mean.
All right, I'm listening now.
You know I've been a bit at sea recently.
Adrift in an open boat, my love.
Yeah, in a thick fog. But you've seemed certain and clear. It's made me think.
About what?
I've been jumping through hoops at work. The whole Jackson thing, putting my family in danger, trying to prove how great I was.
You don't have to prove anything to Bracken and me.
Well, she was the start of it.
What, you're saying this is her fault?
No, no, of course not, but she's changed things.
How?
There was one minute I was a successful solicitor.
And you still are for the time being.
Single-minded, knew what I wanted, no distractions.
So you're saying our daughter is a distraction to you now?
No, no, she's brought many, many positives, but somewhere along the way, I've got caught up in the bigger picture and I've lost sight of the bits and pieces.
Such as?
Well, me, what I want to do, who I am.
And where does your family fit into all this?
I need to gain control of my life again. I can't do that at Riley Lynch anymore. That's why I need to leave.
It's just such a big risk. What if you don't get another job?
Oh, I will.
You know what this place is like. Word gets out that you've walked out on Riley Lynch and, well, people might not be willing to take the risk.
Well, that's just it. If I play this right, I won't need anyone to offer me anything.
I'm sorry, you've lost me.
Don't worry about it. I've got it all sorted out. I'm going to set up my own practice.
It's clearly the scan of an older baby. 6 months, I'd say.
Where did you get it?
Off the internet.
There was no record of you at the maternity clinic.
Why didn't you say something earlier?
Well, I wasn't 100% sure, and I wanted to check a St. Phil's.
Leanne, you knew I'd find out one day.
I was going to pretend that I lost it. I had a miscarriage.
But why?
I've seen what people are like with Kelly. Made a fuss over her. Treated her like she was somebody.
Is that what this is about, being popular?
I just want people to love me.
There are people who love you.
No.
There's your nan. And Pickles. My mum's cat.
Anybody else?
And there's me. I love you. What is it now?
You've never said that to me before.
I didn't think I had to. Thought it was obvious.
Not obvious enough.
I'm your mum. That's what we do, love our kids. Come here.
Of course I'll support you, but they'll be setting up costs.
We've got a bit put by.
Not for a rainy day.
George Moran says chucking it down. Just think of it as an investment for all of us.
I just think that maybe the timing's wrong.
How do you mean?
Well, Bracken's not even at school yet.
Nursery's been a big help. It's freed us both up.
Mm-hmm. And with my job changing, I'm going to need to focus on work more.
What am I meant to do in the meantime?
It won't be for long.
Now how long? 6 months? A year? Two?
I don't know.
My life has been on hold long enough. I'll need to take charge again.
Yeah, so you keep saying.
So where's the problem? What if it was the other way around?
What do you mean?
Well, all your plans recently, complementary therapies, threatening to walk out of the mill if they didn't agree to what you wanted. Did you stop to consider Bracken and me?
Of course I did.
Yeah, did it stop you?
Well, I thought you agreed.
I do, but what if I didn't? Would it have made a difference?
Probably not.
Well then, it's time I started looking after myself, isn't it?
Fighting Your Corner, Watchdog, investigating consumer complaints tonight at 8. Diagnosis Murder next this afternoon here on BBC One sees Dr. Sloan eyewitness to a courtroom killing. To watch tonight.
It's mass cheap produce.